the sex party. One dark, rainy Saturday afternoon, Thomas and Alfred drove their cows up to a cool green pasture in the mountains to have an argument over money with their wife, Eloise.
Buy me more jewelry.
Thomas and Alfred lost their temper and killed Eloise.
Not big surprise.
Then they ate supper and worked in the garden and went to sleep. A little after midnight, Thomas heard someone singing
louder than ever.
Alfred, Thomas said,
"Hello."
Alfred replied, "Please go back to sleep." "No." Then a few minutes later, he heard the singing again. Now it was closer and louder.
Shut your half-wit pie hole!
Thomas screamed,
"No!
Please try."
Oh.
"Cut it out," Thomas said. "It's not funny." When the singing still did not stop, Thomas lost his temper. "Alfred, I'll throw you in the fire," said Thomas, "and that'll be that."
"No!"
Alfred said. "I'll throw
you
in the fire." So Thomas and Alfred took it out on one another.
Suddenly, there was the sound of a crash.
Thomas and Alfred
looked and saw
Harold. Thomas and Alfred were so afraid that they both smoked 1,100 blunts just like that. Harold
danced around and around the room. Faster and faster he went. Then he stopped. And he looked into their eyes. "What do you come for?" they asked in a small voice that shivered and shook. "What do I come for?" he said. "I come to dance,
you motherfucking motherfuckers." Then Thomas became angry. "Let's throw him in the fire," said Thomas.
"Oh,
no!"
Harold
screamed.
Thomas and Alfred grabbed Harold and put him in the fire. Then Thomas had an idea that changed everything. "Let's have a sex party," he said. "It'd be fun to make, and we could fuck for 2 months.
"That's a good idea," said Alfred.
"I'm going to call your mama
to the party."
The very next night, Thomas and Alfred started their sex party. It was 9 o'clock in the evening. There were Richard, Brian, a boy, and his father, a farmer, Jim, the worms, 2 farmhands,
a blacksmith,
alligators, a man named Joseph Blackwell,
death,
Ed Cox, Sam and his cousin Bob, George Flint, John Nicholas, a rattlesnake, the not sea cows,
Billy Mansfield,
Silas Burton,
Nicholas Cage,
Billy
Mays, Tom Connors,
Tim Burton,
Samuel Blunt,
Donald Trump,
and of course Thomas and Alfred. They looked one another over, and Donald Trump asked,
"Shall we do it now?"
"No," said the others.
"Let's wait till
King Big Booty and the Mexicans
come."
Donald Trump
stopped and asked in a small voice that shivered and shook,
"Mexicans?" Just then,
the telephone rang.
"Hello," Donald Trump said.
"This is the
Mexican,"
a man said.
"We're
coming very soon now," the man said.
And he hung up. Donald Trump
screamed
and broke through the door.
"I will build a great, great wall."
Then he ran and ran and ran and ran until he thought his lungs would burst. In his fear and confusion, Donald Trump ran to Mexico.
Got you!
There was an eerie silence.
Suddenly, the front door flew open and in walked
King Big Booty.
"What do you come for?"
Thomas asked.
"I come to
fuck you, miserable mole." "Fuck
no,"
Thomas said.
"I'll fuck you
in the big booty." Alfred became angry.
This is stupid, said Alfred.
Suddenly,
Alfred grabbed King Big Booty,
twisted his long, bony fingers into
King Big Booty's
crown, pulled back his head, and sank his teeth into his big butt.
King Big Booty
screamed.
There was a
big fight.
As people watched, the fight was getting pretty big.
Oh no!
In the house, there were
men flying in all directions.
Long legs kicking, knee bones knocking, kicking, crashing, sound the roof, pound and pound and pound the roof, pretty crack, down and back, bones popping, bones dropping, pieces popping, round the roof, pound and round the roof,
then everyone died.
Just like that.
Thomas and Alfred
looked and saw everyone aboard
dead.
And they got up and served themselves some hotcakes.
Yum!